a lot of insecurity in this area, and it made quite a number of people be displaced. They lost their property, and many of them were killed, which prompted government to identify IDP camps, internally displaced camps, for these people's safety. However, in 2007, when the war ended, these people started coming back to their former homes. And however, when they were coming back, they again came back with another epidemic disease, and that was the hepatitis E. This hepatitis E was believed to be caused by use of unsanitary sources of drinking water. And the doctors said that hepatitis E attacked mostly the women. And by 2010, over 200 people had lost their lives, most especially women. So you can see that the area was ravaged by the war, then that epidemic, and they have over and over again tried to see that they can be compensated for their lives lost, their property destroyed by the Lord's Resistance Army. And just recently, this month, government the Parliament of Uganda passed 30 billion Uganda shillings for these people's compensation for the loss of their cattle, for the destruction of their property. And that compensation will be for three sub-regions. That is Acholi sub-region, where we're standing right now, Teso sub-region, and Lango sub-region. So those were the areas that were seriously hit by the war, by the civil war that took place for over 25 years. So today, the President of the Republic of Uganda, who is also standing on the NRM ticket, will be here for his second day of campaigns in this sub-region. Remember, yesterday he was in Gulu city, and now today he's in Kitgum district. So what the people of Kitgum are waiting for from the President's message is when they are going to be compensated. How much are they going to be compensated, and how this compensation is going to be conducted. So those are some of the things that the people living in Kitgum district will be waiting for from the President as he's campaigning in Kitgum district today. Back to studios.
A very good morning. Thank you for joining us here on Urban Today. My name is Lynn Komjisha, and definitely it is a Tuesday. Wakey, wakey, wake up already and get going. Work already started and the day already started. So be up and get going. Right, it is Tuesday, and we're glad you're part of us this morning from wherever you are watching Urban Today. Yes, we have people watching from all sorts of places, from all corners of this country and abroad. I have someone watching on the app, yes. I have someone watching us live on the New Vision Digital Experience app down in Tennessee. Yes, that is in Memphis. Thank you very much for being part of this show. Now, those of you who can download the New Vision Digital Experience app, go to your Google Play Store, download the app, and you'll be streaming us live. So if the people watching from Barra, people watching from Kampala, people watching from Kabong, from wherever you are, thank you very much for being part of this show this morning. Now, of course, I'm not alone. I'm with Apollo Mubiru. Apollo, good morning to you. Right. The president, who is the NRM presidential candidate, is expected in Kitgum district today. That is as he goes on his trail of the Acholi sub-region. We have heard from our reporter, Kafuluma, telling us how, of course, war has ravaged the area, but they expect lots of things going, you know, as the president comes in today. They expect to hear from him about their roads, about their industrialization, about a lot of things. And it's a very interesting bit because the president is saying that he is vowing to fix roads, the health sector. This has been his message up in the Acholi sub-region. What are your thoughts on it?
To start with, before I go to President Yoweri Museveni's promises to people of Acholi and Kitgum in particular, Kitgum is a unique. This time around, he goes to Kitgum with a happy heart, having catched, you know, having fished Beatrice
Anywar.
Now, Beatrice Anywar is now in the camp of NRM, and she is standing as a flag bearer for the NRM there. So in the past, he has been going there, but Beatrice Anywar was on the other side. Now, this time around, he goes back with that added advantage of Beatrice Anywar. Mm-hmm. Whether she will win or not, that's a different
story.
But listening to Kafuruma, what Kafuruma has been reporting, he has promised to give them roads and compensation for the war and
yes.
all. He talked of roads, then compensation, and
the health sector.
Yes, yes. I want to say that if he does make this a promise of war compensation, should it this time round, let it be fulfilled, because for the past 20, 25 years, there have been efforts to compensate people virtually for mm-hmm. for what they lost in the war.
Yes.
But I want to say that we should not carry on with compensation or with promises until to the next elections.
Mm-hmm.
If the promise is to compensate, isn't it time that we compensate now and for all?
So
the next presidential campaign,
yes.
we have another promise to give.
That,
because you
true.
Don't put compensation for the war which war ended and now
ages
everybody knows that. So if the promise is to compensate them for the war, let government compensate them once and for all.
That's true. I agree. Totally. He also said that he will take action against leaders who, if any borehole is found in a state of disrepair. So that was yesterday as he campaigned. But I wonder, now is when you need to take action. What has been going on?
Okay, the borehole, I think it's more of local governments and local governments at lower levels.
Yes.
These are the ones which are supposed to take care of, because we have villages and parishes, but you do not expect a LC5 or the Ministry of Water, for that case, to come down to the grassroots to find out.
I think local leaders,
say local council one, LC1, should take charge, because in our villages, we are not very many people. If we are to use a borehole, about 20 or 50 households will be using that. Now,
that's
the
true.
Problem is that the local council, LC1 chairperson, do not look at some of the issues that benefit the population or the entire village. They sometimes look at things where they'll get a penny from. Yes,
know.
But if we enforce, say, bylaws on boreholes, these are the do's at the boreholes and these are the don'ts on the boreholes. And I know district councils have what they call production departments.
That's true.
If the borehole has broken down, where do I report?
Uh-huh.
Do not wait for the president to come to the next election to fix. I mean, if a president does fix boreholes, and in this case, I don't even expect a minister to fix, but that's why we have local councils.
That's
so
true.
Let's take charge of our health in
Absolutely. All right, away from the NRM camp, here's what's happening in the Chagulanyi camp. He was yesterday traversing the Busoga region, and he vowed to revive factories in Busoga region. He also promised to promote education. Anyway, it's good to promise these things, you know, to tell us and get us excited. What has been happening in Busoga? Because Busoga, for the longest time, has been thought to be one of those poverty corridors.
Okay, when you talk of poverty, then you bring Busoga next. It has always been like that. But looking at the pictures that you will see all in New Vision or Bukede,
yes.
I think this time around, all Busoga showered Bobby Wine
with
love. It was real love. Now, for people of Busoga, they've had a number of people serving this government. The
yes.
Speaker of Parliament comes there.
That's
at
true.
One time, they
That's
had the
true.
Vice President for over 9 years.
That's true.
But they have been left behind in terms of economic empowerment. I don't know whether it's the Busoga who do not want to work. I don't know whether it's... But when you talk of poverty, then you talk of Busoga. And you remember sometime they even had the problem of jiggers.
Thank
God that that was sorted. Mm. But Busoga is one of those poor regions. Now, when he does, Kyagulanyi promise that he will look into the schools and construct factories, I think it's some good news that people of Busoga want to hear. When people are frustrated, or they will get to receive any kind of
are you looking at those numbers?
Yes, the numbers are big.
But that is illegal.
It is illegal according to Electoral Commission, because yesterday police, the Electoral Commission chairperson said that the candidates should not endanger their lives and also should not endanger the lives of those who will vote for them. And this morning, I've seen the police has issued
a warning
to police commanders who fail to put to reduce or to disperse those crowds. But I don't want to say that the next camp voting January 14th is a matter of life and death. Mm. But I think people are simply trying to send a message and signal somewhere that this is what we are and this is what we stand for.
Wow! I'm really amazed at that crowd. But people, you don't know what you're picking from that crowd, because none of them is wearing a mask. And you should start putting your leaders to question. You know, you're supporting them, yes, but are you safe? They are not wearing masks. You're not wearing masks. Tomorrow you might not be able to vote. You should think about that. Well, so Kyagulanyi there promised industries and education to foster employment opportunities and, of course, development in Busoga sub-region. But today he is proceeding to Butaleja, Tororo and Busia. So we shall see how that will go for him later today. Now, to the FDC camp, Amuriat has expressed shock over poor state of roads in Lango region. That's where he was. And while there, his car and motorcade got into some sort of muddy situation. They got stuck in a muddy section of the road as they went to pedal, and they had to step out and start pushing their vehicles.
Yeah.
Remember, he's campaigning on foot, and he's now in the muddy.
I've seen a beautiful picture in Bukede. It really illustrates how the situation was for him.
I know.
A barefooted presidential candidate who pushes his van and it cannot go anywhere.
At some point, he fell.
He fell.
Yes.
Lynn, yesterday, the Electoral Commission had a meeting with some of the presidential candidates and their agents.
Yes.
Now, according to Electoral Commission Chairperson Justice Byabakama, he said they wanted to remind them about the swaps and the rest.
Yes.
But what came came out clearly from, say, candidate John Katumba and candidate Willie Mayambala and the representative from FDC, they said the roads are so bad. And because of the season, the rainy season, they cannot be able to go to place to plan venues on time. In fact, in his words, candidate Katumba, he was calling upon government. See, in fact, for him, he believes it's an intention of government not to work on roads such that they could not reach them. In fact, he said, I think they intended it that they don't work on roads such that we don't reach out to our people. But he insists that they will have to go on with whatever they can
do. Okay, there you have it. There you have it. Amuriat pushing. He doesn't even have energy. Poor guy.
I mean, when you speak to people for a long time, and now that campaigns have gone into about 10th day, that's expected.
Okay.
But also look at the state
finally
of the poor road.
Moves.
Yes.
Oh, right.
Finally.
So at some point, he fell down, and then his colleague, that is Kajinda, Roland Kajinda.
Roland Kajinda, the MP.
Had to, you know, pick him up, and he's washing his feet to step down again. Amuriat, I don't know what you're on. I don't know what you're up to, but with your campaigning, foot shoeless. Well done, anyway. So today, Amuriat heads to Kitgum and Lamo. So hopefully, he doesn't collide with the.
How come that the two are in the same place?
I don't know how that, but that is it. Yes, President Museveni is in Kitgum, Amuriat is in Kitgum.
I think they will use different terms.
So, of course, it must be different timelines. So, there it is for the FDC. General Henry Tumukunde is campaigning. Yesterday was in Bunyangabu district, and he promised to set up industries and add value to their products. Okay, that is General Henry Tumukunde. Everybody is talking about industries and employment. And this brings me back to what the NRM, the current government, has been preaching, that they want to, there's Vision 2040. Then there is the fourth industrial revolution. Yes, so they want to the country to move to the, what is that phase? it just got out of my head. But I think everybody's focusing on industrialization, which is very key.
The way forward, because like we said yesterday, now if you want to employ more youth, which who make the biggest percentage of Uganda, because
that's
the
right.
youth are still energetic, mm-hmm. and they can offer any services that will yield to a wage at the end of the day or the end of the month. So industrialization is one of the key issues that we have to look at. But when you look at industrialization, then you should also look at electrification. I think we have enough power that can support our factories. The issue now is to woo more investors to come to Uganda. But the most important part is to pay the workers at least something.
Something that is tangible, that is good.
Right. Because we've seen very many factories that employ more than 1,000 of Ugandans. But what they take home at the end of the day
is
just peanut.
That's true. Anyway, so I like that at least they're appreciating what the current government has done and want to build on that. For me, that is very key when our candidates are out there campaigning. I would want them to appreciate that the current government has actually done something, but we can add more to this, you know? That, for me, really is the best thing you can do. Now, Henry Tumukunde will proceed to Fort Portal and Kawerole today. Now, Norbert Mao of the DP is campaigning in Chiruhura and Kazo. He says we do not want to force Museveni out. Okay, so who is forcing Museveni out?
I think an election would be targeting the incumbent such that he gets out.
Yes.
But Mao's argument is that I think he calculates his words very well.
He knew where
he was,
uh-huh.
knowing that he was in Kiruhura,
uh-huh.
and you know what Kiruhura means I'm not go into the details. But now he's giving them assurance.
Yes.
Now, if you vote me into power, I'll give the president safe haven and make sure the retired general is well catered for. So, I mean,
he has to, because that we know that is
politics.
That
yeah,
is the president's
politics.
Home base. Mm. So surely he has to try and be nice and smart about it. You don't just go to the incumbent's home and talk for. Right, so he promised to fight unemployment and land grabbing. Away from that, we got General Mugisha Muntu. He says his campaigns have been hit by poor coordination. He was addressing residents of Chibale Trading Center. So today he heads to Sembabule, Kalungu, and Bukomansimbi. Okay, Mayambala failed to show up in Rakai.
I think Mayambala's failure to show up in Rakai. Yesterday, he personally attended that meeting with the Labour Commission.
Yes.
I was there and I saw him. So
but
by the
he
time
he was also here. In the
yes, evening. He left around 2 or 3 p.m. So I think it was hard for him to reach Rakai on time.
Right now. You know, yesterday they were recapping on how the week went with the Electoral Commission. So they sat down, and the Electoral Commission has warned of action against presidential candidates, those who are flouting COVID-19 regulations. Now, the Electoral Commission boss says that they are not out of penalties, okay? They are not out of penalties, but they are choosing dialogue. They want to first sit down and make sense of what's happening and remind the candidates that, people, please, can you take care of your supporters and not, you know, expose them to COVID-19? But if that fails, he says that the candidates can be recalled, reprimanded, or their campaigns put to halt for some time. And this is very, very important. But what caught my attention, Apollo?
I know is... you're heading unpresidential of some candidates. Oh.
I have to use border as a public means. That was so funny.
Okay, now, I was there when he was addressing the press. Right. Justice Byabakama said, okay, two presidential candidates, that's Willie Mayambala and John Katumba,
yes,
in there, what, according to Justice Byabakama,
yes,
had requested Electoral Commission to give them vehicles
to move.
Mm. In fact, they were reminding the Electoral Commission that we are the property of the state, so please cater for us. But the word from Justice Byabakama was that we are not parliament. That's corrupt. By the
way,
in the past, presidential candidates were supposed to get an official vehicle and an escort van.
Yeah.
But he said, we are not parliament. That's corrupt. If they want that, for us, we implement what is
in the law.
But warning that it's also presidential, a presidential candidate.
I said to use a board.
I think that follow pictures that were awash on social media the other day when candidate Willie Mayambala used the border and the escort had to go.
And then Katumba took public means to a road.
It reminds me of the lady we hosted here who said that the presidential candidates ought to have read the preamble. There are certain things that they expect of them, and they should behave in a way that will show Ugandan that they're really presidential candidates,
right,
and they are here to...
But this one's quite unpresidential. Too bad. The police has also threatened to punish commanders who fail to disperse campaign crowds, illegal mass campaign gatherings, and they have also told them that if you must disperse a crowd, first make pronouncements. First tell the public, you have 5 minutes or we release tear gas.
Mm.
You know, so if you do not want to be part of that mess, it is good for you to run away. So they have given you that.
On police warning commanders using tear gas, yesterday at the Electoral Commission, we had a senior police officer, Edward Ochom.
Yes.
I may not put his ranks in right. But he said that people are blaming us for using tear gas.
Uh-huh.
Tear gas is a non-lethal method that we are using. But any police officer above the command, above the assistant AISP rank can use a firearm. The law allows us to use a firearm.
So but we haven't,
but we have not yet used that. But now, Aline, I want you to read from Edward Ochom's comment and what the police has said. Mm-hmm. I think we are yet to see more now.
We haven't seen anything. And they're going to give us all sorts of funny excuses. But yes, people, just be safe.
But I wonder whether a police officer who is quailing or dispersing a crowd will use a microphone to say, I'm giving you 5 minutes. Now, after 5 minutes elapse, I'm using tear gas. I'm yet to see that, and I'm waiting to see that. I think campaignism is going to have two
Omega. Oh no, this is very, very interesting.
Mm.
Okay, guys, that is what's happening in, of course, the campaigning. But now, today, we'll take a look at today's quote. Working hard becomes a habit, a serious kind of fun. You get self-satisfaction from pushing yourself to the limit, knowing that all the effort is going to pay off. Working hard becomes a habit, a serious kind of fun. You get self-satisfaction from pushing yourself to the limit, knowing that all the effort is going to pay off. How wonderful can that be? This is exactly my experience.
Right.
I have to wake up early in the morning because I know at the end of the day, this is going to pay off.
Yeah, right. I also woke up yesterday when it was raining.
I know.
I used public means to office, but I mean, we have to put food on the table.
Absolutely.
And every time you try your way, God will also reward you.
Absolutely. And that push is what you need. It is the motivation you need because at the end of the day, you'll be smiling.
All right,
so we're going to take a breather and take a look at what's happening in the papers.
New vision, Bukede.
Mom.
Let's first do new vision, Bukede.
Don't be near one another. Put on the mask. I have removed my mask because I am alone here with a few people. this Nambole Stadium, what we called Mandela Stadium. That stadium was supposed to be built in 1968, but when they were about to start, then there was chaos. The government collapsed. I mean, came in, killings and so on. Everybody is produced by a woman. But somehow women were looked down. You are a woman. You are like a woman. Really, the one who pushes all these fellows around. I can't push even 2 kilograms of anything. These drugs are being stored. But fortunately, we have found now a computer system that is able to trace the medicine from the factory to the national medical stores, to the district, to the health center, up to the patient. Can the parents afford? If they can't afford, then why do we insist on these school charges? So you, the people, you report. There is this, our lady, Nakarema. If you could report to me, to her, because she can record, the boreholes which are not working in your village. And then you find out what these people are doing. The cow, the RDC, they just keep quiet as if there is no problem.
Urban Today, indeed. Thank you for joining us from wherever you're watching from. Download the New Vision Digital Experience app and be with us. Trust me, it is the best experience ever because you go there and we shall be interacting with you live. Okay, so today in the papers, in the dailies, we have government to zone private schools. This is the New Vision at only 2,000 Uganda shillings, and you'll have all these details. So Museveni calls for negotiations in Ethiopia conflict. By the way, that's a very interesting one to watch out for and see how it goes. Pastor Semanda charged, remanded, get yourself a copy. Murder of members of parliament, God, what exactly happened? Yes, get yourself a copy of the New Vision and see what it is all about. Today's Tuesday, we have past A-level mathematics. We also have biology, we have physics. There's so much in the New Vision. And in our business section today, UN Stanbic partner to help SMEs. Harbor researcher, government in mediation. There's a harbor researcher who took government to court for funny reasons. Okay, so her vision. Jill Biden, from classroom to White House. Did you know the wife of president-elect for the U.S.? Get yourself a copy of the New Vision. And in sport, a champion some find hard to like. Who is that? I'll be back. Keep Rotich. Prayers. It is a game of chance for the Cranes. Yesterday they were beaten by South Sudan. So watch out and get yourself a copy of what the latest that is. So get yourself a copy of 2,000 Uganda shillings. Bukede is here. Munasingo, chiche chigenda mas.
Valabi ba Urban Today, mwavali nyoku tulaba. Wanayo musinzi lukwedanga mtulaba. Ze Munasingo semu genyi siraje mtawani umusaji wa mwili mimu zikula jaja mazige. Bukede vili muno, bizibu nyo. Kubanga pasta igasinga badda akyali mulamuloza naye senga tagenda mukomera nebuza bwebuza nze kubanga bagamba nti bane ba pasta igabiza bonna ba batandisa okweranga bakwata eresa wayo nayo na bandi weranga bagenda mukomera ne bakulaga no magika imamu bokedde mchalo no bena namisinga mubokedde olunako olwaliro obalengera obufana nyo obutono buli wansi kakati wana abaana ba show kubanga ekintu bachiko ya damagi kaimo badochi manye bena na misinga yabadde mucha obayi mchalo wa pastor Siraje Semanda nesi Siraje nze Trump chile wa Trump chikambwe batubuli dentiono chali ya soro sena kilizanti ya wangudua afana nyenga president yali president wa Gambia Yahya Jammeh aso senala ganti awangudua nakiriza to oluvanyuma nefuli ya mchitinge embazi na majega amulabudde kakati wagamba mu ngeri yokuyiya sente mubukedde nti igengeri jokola mu sente mukatungulu chumu byonna mubukedde olunako olwalero nebakulaga nti no a police abasirikali ngabambadde ngoye za bulijjo basazeeko amaka gabena namisinga ne magi kayima basirikali police bakedde waabwe olunaku olweggulo kati byonna byonna birimbukedde olwaleero ye Pastor Siraji aguddwako emisango 17 bukedde yabikubuulidde mu bo bisanga nakugamba nti engeri obunkenke gye buzinzeeko Kasalini kusaasira ne banne baayiga byonna byonna ogenda kubeera ng'obiraba wategeddeko nti nno omukyala Nakalima yayise kusaasira ne Pastor Mondo byonna mubukedde ogenda kubeera ng'obisangamu Museveni agambye nti ngenda kukola ebintu bingi nnyo mwacyoli biki byagenda okola wofuna bukedde ogenda kubeera ng'obitegeera ye amuli ati yalabiddwako ng'asindika mmotoka eno bwagwa ebigo kabika abadde kamanyi nyo bagamba enguudo mbi Museveni takoze kimala kakati tumukunde abagambye nti bavuukamu emunannonda nze njobbawo emirimu n'olwekyo mumpe omukisa nsobole okubeera nga waakiri mbakulembera ye mawu n'agamba nyinaawo okukuumirayo likaguta Museveni alamula kuno singa munnonda Museveni nze njomukuuma ayogerweko nti mawu ye yamukulembeze yawa Museveni oboolyawo obudda mu nsi ye Kyagulanye Ssentamu Bobi Wine bamwaniriza mu busoga abantu bakiridde erizi ne bawuganga poliisi eggadde amakubo mubalina oyita okusinkana Kyagulanyi bo ne bakka emyala ne batandika okuga tumusinkane Trump agonza ate ne yeefuula biri mu bukedde ate ne Mugisha Muntu naye alina bingi byakuteereddemu ne bakubuulira abasente bali ku ddembe nti waakiri bayimiriza empooza ate ne bategeeza nti gavumenti yeddiza akatale ekitundu ku katale k'ewakiseka byonna byonna biri mu bukedde olunaku olwaleero bw'omufuna ogenda kubeera nga obaoliawo obimanya n'okusingawo kakati nno ne bakubuulira wane eno nti waliwo Kabaka omu ku bakulu gw'atendereza abadde mukulu kyono batugambye nti Kabaka atendereza omukulu Nkambo olw'ebirungi byakoledde Buganda biki bwona osoma bukedde olunaku olwaleero ogenda kubeera ng'obitegeera ate oyimaleyo kati senga n'ensonga z'abaana mwebiri bakubuulya engeri gy'oyinza otendekamu omwana ng'akyali muto n'afuuka omukulembeze ow'enkya ate ambukedde mwe muli senga n'abanoonya nabo mwebaliba nabono yaani omusajja wange ono gwenkola naye omutegedde kakati ogenda bifuna ambukedde n'engeri abakyala bagambye nti wadde twakolamu ffe ne tunoonya abasajja nga nabo baakolamu nga balina kuwaaka kati gwa talina waka tojja mbukedde olwaleero ng'oyagala mukyala ebyenjigiriza P4 ne P5 byonna mbukedde olunaku olwaleero mwebiri so katugendeko mbi emizanyo katono jageni club abazanyi basatu balwadde ba defender kakati agambye nze ndi mugumu sigenda kunoonya muzibizimu bwangu ate cranes ne batugambye esudde bijulidde omusajja agambye nti bibe bibiri watu biragera avuwa neno katugendeko mukasembayo olwaleero olwakadde katutwala tugenda mu bunyumero bwaffe bw'abantu baffe ono agambye nti awali ssente tewabula awali sente tewabula sanyu na kaseko eh? Kati muganda wange awuliriza bobo yagala okufuna akaseko ku matama we yagaleko olina okubeera ne sente akasembayo ko kagamba nti oluusi ate abalinawo be basinga okubeera abeetaava ennyo babeera nga buli kadde bayayana okubeera nga beegattako yaayana nawe weegatteko ato obeereko abalinawo kankutwale wamunywanyi ate akutwale mu Daily Monitor.
Here in the Daily Monitor this morning, the lead says candidates cry out to Electoral Commission over brutality. The 6 out of 11 presidential candidates tell Electoral Commission that they have been tear gassed, brutalized by police just after 1 week into the campaigns. The Daily Monitor leads with a telling picture of how police and the army were blocking a crowd from joining candidate Kyagulanyi in Busoga. There is also another interesting story that Busoga asks Kyagulanyi to save them from poverty. Save us from poverty, Busoga asks Kyagulanyi. So to them, it's Kyagulanyi who can end poverty from Busoga. DP's Mbide abandons Mao back to Bobi Wine. Ah, that's a story. According to the Daily Monitor, MP Mbide says that the number of people who are in Masaka contesting on no ticket don't want to see Kyagulanyi winning. They simply want to lean on him to get, but for him, he's back. I think he's simply getting to where his heart has always been. So there is a story there about Mbide and DP in Masakaba says to Tanzania resume operations after 8 months. That's good news. Then RDC Opondo disagree on fate of independence. That's a story can also get in the Daily Monitor. Get the rest of these stories from all these newspapers at your nearest newsstand.
Right, thank you, Apollo. Thank you, Munasingo. Get yourself, actually, subscribe. This is the simplest way. Subscribe to our e-papers. You have access to all these stories in the New Vision, in Bukede, and all other products under Vision Group. But the New Vision Digital Experience app is interesting. Get yourself a copy. I'm here seeing that some 263 of you are watching, and from wherever you are, thank you very much for making it a part of your morning. We'll take a breather right now. We're still talking politics, campaigns, party intrigue. We're seeing parties are complaining. They're being targeted, brutalities here and there. Campaigns are, some of them are being blocked. And how are the campaigns actually progressing for some candidates? Perhaps they're not seeing any problems. Yesterday I saw that someone's poster was taken to police.
Really?
Yeah, the person be where he is.
Properly. So some of these things, we're going to sit and delve into those, discuss how that and all those are going, and how best you and I can actually participate and be very safe and be less violent, but also making sure that you wear your mask, your hand sanitize, rather you carry a hand sanitizer, beg your pardon, and you make sure you wash your hands. Please, please, COVID is serious. We are registering more and more cases every single day. As I speak, we have new deaths, 5 new deaths of COVID-19. We have 16,257 of our people have had COVID-19. So you're there gallivanting, walking around for, something is going to happen to you. Be very careful. Let's take a breather. We'll return with that discussion in just a bit.
In the New Vision this Tuesday, the Electoral Commission has threatened action against defiant candidates. Find out what could happen and who would be the culprits. The government will soon release new rules on setting up schools. Is there any problem that necessitated this? Read the New Vision. The detailed story behind the murder of Member of Parliament Bodyguard is in the New Vision. Get a copy. President Yoweri Museveni has spoken out about the Ethiopian conflict. Find out what he said would be the solution. Police commanders who fail to disperse crowds are in trouble. Find out what awaits them. Minister Kamia has saved a number of families from eviction. Get the full story and detailed stories of various candidates. These and so much more in your copy of the New Vision this Tuesday. New Vision, New Vision.